So let's look at our code. We have this pattern that is being repeated over and over. What do? We have a variable and we're computing something that may return false, and false represents an error here. So we have to assign the value of the argument, right? We have to evaluate some code and that will return some value. We need to assign that value to an argument, to a result, right? And this result, if the result is false, then we should abort the computation. Otherwise, we should proceed with a continuation. Afterwards, we're doing the same thing, right? So we have some code that we're gonna execute. We're gonna then assign the result of that to a variable, call that arg2. And then what we're gonna do is, if there's an error in that code, abort computation, otherwise continue with something else that has access to arg2. Right? So let's try to write this code. Right? So this is kind of the code that is repeating over and over. And this is the continuation of something, right? So let's call this define handle error. So what does define handle error does? Let's see. So it takes some value, v, which represents this whole thing, v. And then what do we do with v? Well, if v is false, then return v. Otherwise, what do we do? Otherwise, we are here. And we must have access to arg1. So how do we make it so that arg1 is visible to some code that follows it? That's right, we use a lambda. So we need some kind of continuation k, and what that continuation k takes is the value that is not erroneous, right? So something like this would work, right? Internally, we are abstracting this check. Is this an error? If it is an error, return the error. Otherwise, continue with function k to handle the value. So we have to propagate the value directly to k. So let's try to do that. Okay, so how would we do it? Let's do it backwards because it's going to be easier. So first we want to refactor this handle error. What do we want to handle? We want to handle this code. What is the second argument of handle error? It's going to be a function. So lambda, what are we going to take? It's argument 2. Okay. So now this is going to be all refactored. The only thing we want to do is we want to return whatever was there. So this corresponds to the whole pattern, right? So handle error, it's gonna take the result of this. And if the result is not false, it's gonna call this lambda and pass the result to arg2, which is now visible in the continuation function that can safely handle arg2 without having to do the check. Okay, so now we wanna do the same thing here, right? So what we wanna do is we wanna do handle error. Did we call handle error? Yes, we did. Okay, we want to handle the error. Now we do a lambda that takes an arg1. This is all refactored out. Now it seems like we have okay. So we changed it, and now our function handle error is abstracting the error checking, right? It's handling the error for us. We call the function, we call whatever, we pass that result to handle error. It will handle the error for us, and if it deems the result not erroneous, it will proceed and execute whatever lambda we pass it. Right, so now let's see if this works as expected. Okay, so we pass the same expression and it still returned false, so it's working as expected. Great. So we did this. So what are we doing now? What is this example? Okay, we want to add a modulo to our thing. Just a second, I need to figure out what's going on here. Got it, I remember. Let's just copy this to our code. What we will see is if we copy paste this here. So what this is doing is okay, so now we're calling modulo, which is a function that was not defined in built-ins. Right? Built-ins does not have modulo. So if I try to run this, what do I get? I got an error saying, well, the application is expecting a function, but it got F, right? So we could also, that means that eval, where is it? Our function, where is it? This part. So when we evaluate a built-in, that itself could also throw an error. So let's try to refactor that. Let's call this F. So what we could do is another handle error where we evaluate the function and we, given the function, we finally call it. So now we are also taking care of the case where the lookup of a function, of a symbol, you know, if this returns false, then by handling the error of looking up a function, we also are able to cope with that. That's basically what I wanted to show in this example. So if we run it again, instead of getting application not error, now we should get, if I fix the parentheses, see if I can fix the parentheses. Okay. Now I get false rather than an application contract error. Okay. But as we can see, this is kind of ugly because it's so nested, right? So it would be nice if we could clean this up. Oh my God, this is so stupid. Okay, ignore the indentation. We call it, we got false, everything is fine. Code looks a bit ugly. How do we fix this? Have we seen this before? Have we seen this before is the question. And yes, we have seen this before, right? This pattern is exactly the bind pattern, right? We have bind where we're assigning the result to a variable func, which is given as a function. And we can even, we even saw how to use a macro to kind of clean this up. But this is exactly the same pattern that we saw before in the last lesson.